Namaste, beautiful souls. Let's begin at the front of the mat. Feet hip distance apart, shoulders back and down, heart lifts, crown of the head lifts. Press equally into all four corners of the feet. Close the eyes. Take a deep inhale. And slow exhale. Another long, full inhale. And slow, complete exhale. A few more breaths here. This class is for rainy days, cold days, so it will be quick and powerful. Get the blood moving, but it's important to start by tuning into the present, tuning into the breath. So take a few moments here to let everything else fall away. Here and take your feet a little wider than hip distance apart, toes facing out a little, and we'll bend at the knees and turn over to the left, and then bend and turn to the right. So you're just letting your knees come into these twists. Let your arms lead. There's no right or wrong, and let your arms be limp or stiff. Just opening up the spine, opening up across the shoulders. Inhale, come back to center, reach. Exhale, the flat back fold. You can leave your knees bent or straight. Shake your head yes and no. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. And inhale, swoop the arms down, around, and up. Clasp at the top and reach over to one side. Side bend. Make sure your body's in one straight plane. And over to the other side. Back to center, reach. And exhale, swoop the arms down. Forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. Bend through the right knee. Press your right hand into the mat. Inhale, the left arm up. Twist. Press back with the left hip. And from here, take your right hand next to your right foot and slide the left foot back in a warrior two alignment, side angle. Reach up and overhead. Plant the left hand, pop the left heel up, and hop forward back to forward fold. Left hand on the mat, bend through the left knee, inhale, right arm reach. And then take the left hand on the inside of the left foot, slide the right foot back, side angle. Reach up and over. Plant the right palm, hop forward fold. Inhale, half lift, flat back, navel up and in. And exhale, plant the palms and step it back to plank. Spread the fingers wide. Give me a strong plank. Core tight. Heels pressing away from you. And from here, we'll do 10. Hop out and hop in, or you can step out and step in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Chaturanga to upward facing dog. Chaturanga to downward facing dog. Deep breath in, slow breath out. Inhale the right leg up. Circle. Take a few circles with the foot in one direction and then the other. Then step it through. Drop the back heel down and windmill the arms up, warrior two. With the right hand, reverse the warrior. Come back up, side angle, either with your elbow on your knee or hand on the mat. Reach up and overhead. Enjoy the stretch. And plant the palm. Step the right foot back to meet the left. Plank. And from here, lift the right heel up. Pump at the top. And then left heel up. Pump. 10. 1, 2, 3. Spread the fingers wide. 4, 5. Core tight. 6, 7, 8. Chaturanga, upward facing dog, second chaturanga to downward facing dog. Inhale the left leg up, leg circles, first one way and then the other. And step it through. Come up, drop the back heel down, warrior two. Flip the left palm, reverse the warrior. Inhale back through. And drop into side angle. Make sure you press through the outer edge of the back foot. Make sure it stays on the mat. Reach up and overhead. Plant the palms. Step it back to plank. Now take the right foot, bend the knee, thread it through to the left. Come onto your right hand and tap your toe. Back to plank, put the foot down, left knee bends. Drop your hips to the left, touch your left foot with your right hand. We'll do 10. Thread it through. 10. When you're done, come back to plank. Chaturanga to upward facing dog. To chaturanga to downward facing dog. Take a couple deep breaths here. Shake your head yes and no. Release all the tension in the neck. Shoulders away from the ears. Inhale the right leg up. Exhale. Step it through. Drop the back heel down and windmill the arms up. Warrior two. Take your right foot and turn it towards the front of the side of the room so that both feet are somewhat in the same direction. You might have to hop your back foot in a little bit. Bend through the right knee, hips back, knee behind or above the ankle, not above the toes, and side lunge. So from side lunge, press back up to a standing position. So we're almost in wide-legged forward fold, except without the fold, with our feet position. So then re-bend through the right knee and come back up. One. Re-bend through the right knee. Make sure you press your hip back. Two. Re-bend. Engage through the glutes. Think about your booty as you press back up so you can feel that muscle moving, working in the glutes. Three, four, five. Heart open, heart lift. Six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Return that foot back towards the front of the room. Bend through the leg, plant the right palm side angle. Reach up and over, plant the palms, plank. This time, 10, knee in. So bring your knee in between your elbows and step back. Other knee in between your elbows and step back. 10, 1, cool. 2, core tight, 3, 4, go slow, 5, 6, 7, when you're done, chaturanga. Upward facing dog. Chaturanga to downward facing dog. Big breath in, slow breath out. Walk it out. Inhale the left leg up. Exhale, step it through. Drop the back heel down. Warrior two. Virabhadrasana 2. Relax the shoulders down the spine. Bend deeply through the left knee. Lift through the heart. Now turn the left toes in a little bit at a diagonal. You might need to move the feet a little bit closer. Bend through the knee, press the hips back, and lift back up. Make sure that you are engaging, you're squeezing the glute muscle, you're paying attention to it. You're thinking about using that muscle to press yourself back up to standing. And we'll do 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, heart lifts, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. When you're done with the 10th one, turn your toes back towards the front of the room, bend through the knee, drop the hand, side angle, reach up and over, plant the palms. Step it back to plank. And from here, we will do 10 knee to same elbow. So bring your right knee to your right elbow, step it back. Left knee to left elbow, step back. One, core tight. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Chaturanga to upward facing dog. Second chaturanga to downward facing dog. Walk it out, bend one knee and then the other. Inhale the right leg up. Exhale, step it through. Drop the back heel down and windmill the arms up, warrior two. Now turn those right toes towards the front of the room. Bend through the right knee, lunge. And this time, when you press back up through the lunge, you pop up, right knee to left elbow. Step back into lunge, press up, pop up, right knee to left elbow. So it's easier to do it if you have a little momentum, but try to go slow and we had a little bit of core workout in too. Not that we haven't been with planks, but bend through the right knee, press up, knee to elbow. One. Two. Don't press too hard, you'll fall over the other side. Three. Core tight. Four. Five. Squeeze your obliques when you twist. Six. Seven. Eight, nine, 10. So then turn your right toes back to the front of the mat, side angle, reach up and overhead, and then straighten through the right leg, triangle pose. Open through the left side body, rock your left hip back. Your hands can be on the floor, on your shin, on your thigh, not on your knee. And reach up and overhead, plant the palms, walk your hands over to the other side of the room. Turn your left toes to face the back of the room, right toes slightly in, and windmill your arms up, warrior two. Turn your left toes towards the front diagonal of the room. Bend through the left knee and press up, knee to elbow. We'll do 10. One. Two. It's okay if you can't do it in one move. Do your best. Three. Four. Five. Toes back out to the side or the front back, whichever way of the mat, side angle. Reach up and overhead and then straighten through the left leg, triangle pose. Move your hand wherever you need to. Open through the right side body. Try to find a long straight spine, so don't round, just to get to the floor. So reach up and overhead and then plant the right palm. Walk your hands to the center of the mat, turn the toes to face parallel. Inhale, half lift with a flat back, and exhale, fold, forward fold, wide legged forward fold. inhale, half lift, bend through the right knee. Take your hands to just glide along the mat. And then glide them over to the left, bend through the left. So kind of like drawing figure eights with your hands and your hips. Do a few of these. See if you can find the movement in your shoulders as well as in your spine. Let your head get into it. Just find something that feels good and open and fluid in your body. Center. Bend through the right knee. Straighten the left leg. Flex the foot to the sky. Side lunge. You can take your right hand to the outside of your right leg and open your left arm up. Bring your left hand to the mat. Come up onto your left foot now, and just feel a little bit of a nice inner thigh stretch here. Now over to the other side, bend through the left knee, right foot to the sky, left hand on the outside of the left foot, reach. Plant the palms, bring your right foot back to the mat. Just stretch in this side lunge variation. Come back through center. Walk over to the front of the mat in lizard. So make sure that your hands are on the inside of your right foot. Bring your left knee to the mat. Right knee to shoulder. Come onto your forearms if that's where you like to. I'm feeling a little tight today, so I think I'll stay up on the hands. And now turn the back toes under, hop the left foot up to the front of the mat, sink the hips, yogi squat. Long, deep inhale. Slow, complete exhale. Plant the palms. Step the right foot back this time. Drop the right knee to the mat. Lizard. This time, you bring your left leg back to meet the right. Bring your knees just slightly apart, distance apart, I suppose. Come up onto your knees. And take your hands behind your head with your elbows out. And we'll do 10. Squeeze your right elbow to your left side. So you're using the obliques. Back to center and then left elbow to right side. Back to center. So you really have to squeeze the obliques here, okay? No cheating. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. 10. Excellent. You can come down onto sit between your heels. Walk your hands back behind you. You can come onto your forearms, all the way onto your back. Yogi's choice, just make sure that your knees are down. Lengthen your tailbone towards your knees. Stretch, enjoy. To tabletop, just to swing your knees around to the side, come to sit on your bum. Take your legs long in front of you, flex the toes, inhale, lift with a flat back, find length in the spine, engage the core, and as you bend forward, keep that flat back as you bend forward. So you don't want to round just to get to your feet. If you bend from the core, you don't get as far necessarily, but you get a better stretch in the area in the hamstrings. When you round your back, you're obviously stretching your back, not your hamstrings. So flex the feet, come at it with a long, straight spine, and see how far that gets you. If it's not very far, just hang out there, that's okay. Over time, get farther. But the alignment comes first. Once you have the alignment, then you can progress. If you progress without the alignment, then you risk hurting yourself down the line. Nobody wants that. Inhale, come back up. Take your right foot to the inside of your left thigh. Inhale, reach once again, flat back, exhale, fold. Your hands back up, changing sides, right leg long, left foot to the inside of the right thigh. Inhale, reach, exhale, fold. To the mat, hip distance apart, toes facing directly out, roll down onto your back, or directly, not out, you don't want your toes to face out, come directly parallel with your hips, with your knees. So press down through the soles of the feet, press your elbows into the mat, lift your hips into bridge pose, and then you might need to walk your feet out just slightly, and lift your toes, so you're only on your heels. In bridge pose. Shimmy your shoulders up underneath your heart space, lift through the hips, and then we'll pulse. So squeeze your thighs together, not touching, but like energetically squeeze your thighs together, and pulse up and down. We'll do 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, slow. 5, squeeze the thighs, 6, lengthen the tailbone away from you, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10 more, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Slowly roll it down, one vertebra at a time. Great job. Bring your right ankle to your left knee, thread your hands behind your left leg, pigeon on the back. And you can stay in this variation or bring your left hand to your right foot and guide it over to the mat on the left. Lift your knee high. You can use your left knee to push your right foot towards you. Lift your knee high and you should be feeling a great stretch all along the outside of your right leg. Or I do. I feel a great stretch all along the outside of my right leg. And I hope you do as well. Back through center, take the right foot to the mat this time, left ankle on the right knee. Thread your hands through, pigeon on the back. And you can stay here or bring your foot to the floor. Back through center. Take your soles of your feet together, knees apart. Lengthen your tailbone away from you. Shoulders underneath heart space. Hands heavy, palms to the sky, eyes closed if they're not there already. And take a few moments here to let go of the breath, let go of the body, let it be heavy. Consciously choose to relax the area in between your eyebrows, to relax your cheeks, your neck, your shoulders, anywhere where you might be unconsciously holding tension. Send your awareness there. The house from squirrels, passing trucks. Find something to be joyful about in this moment. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed the practice. Namaste.